Miley Rae Hemsworth, née Cyrus, born Destiny Hope Cyrus, November 23, 1992, is an American singer, songwriter, and actress. After playing minor roles in the television series Doc and the film Big Fish as a child, she became a teen idol in 2006, starring in the Disney Channel television series Hannah Montana as the character Miley Stewart. Her father, musician Billy Ray Cyrus, also starred in the series, which aired for 4 seasons until 2011. Cyrus has sold more than 20 million albums and 55 million singles worldwide. She has earned 3 number 1 albums on the US Billboard 200 with Meet Miley Cyrus, 2007, Breakout, 2008, and Bangerz, 2013. Her releases The Time of Our Lives, 2009, Can't Be Tamed, 2010, Younger Now, 2017, and She Is Coming, 2019, debuted in the top 5 in the United States, while her album Miley Cyrus and Amp, Her Dead Pets, 2015, was released for free online streaming on SoundCloud. Her upcoming 7th studio album She Is Miley Cyrus is expected to be released in 2019. Further, Cyrus has attained an additional 2 number 1 and 3 top 10 soundtracks credited as Hannah Montana. She has also earned 9 top 10 entries on the US Billboard Hot 100, See You Again, 7 Things, The Climb, He Could Be the One, as Hannah Montana, Party in the USA, Can't Be Tamed, We Can't Stop, Malibu and the chart-topping Wrecking Ball. Cyrus launched her film career as a voice actress in the animated film Bolt, 2008. She starred in the feature films Hannah Montana, The Movie, 2009, and The Last Song, 2010. On television, she was the host of the 2015 MTV Video Music Awards and has hosted Saturday Night Live 3 times since 2011. Cyrus has been featured as a coach on the singing competition television series The Voice. She has appeared in 2 seasons of the show since her debut in 2016. Cyrus has earned numerous awards and nominations. She was recognized as Artist of the Year by MTV in 2013 and was included on the annual Time 100 list of the most influential people in both 2008 and 2014. Cyrus is the first female to enter the Billboard charts under 3 different names, as herself, Hannah Montana, and her Black Mirror character Ashley O. Her image has been the subject of significant media commentary and public controversy, shifting from wholesomeness to highly sexual behavior in the 2010s. Cyrus is an outspoken animal rights advocate, and adopted a vegan lifestyle in 2014. That year, she founded the nonprofit Happy Hippie Foundation, which focuses on youth homelessness and the LGBT community. Life and career. 1992-2002, Early Life and Career Beginnings. Destiny Hope Cyrus was born November 23, 1992, in Franklin, Tennessee, to Letitia, Tish, Jean Finley and singer Billy Ray Cyrus. Her parents married the next year. Cyrus was born with supraventricular tachycardia, a condition causing an abnormal resting heart rate. Her birth name, Destiny Hope, expressed her parents' belief that she would accomplish great things. Her parents nicknamed her Smiley, which they later shortened to Miley, because she often smiled as an infant. In 2008, she changed her name to Miley Ray Cyrus. Her middle name honors her grandfather, Democratic politician Ronald Ray Cyrus from Kentucky. Against the advice of her father's record company, Cyrus's parents secretly married on December 28, 1993, a year after her birth. They had 2 more children together, son Brazon and daughter Noah. From previous relationships, her mother has 2 other children, Brandy and Trace. Her father adopted them soon after the marriage. Her father's first child, Christopher Cody, was born in April 1992. He grew up with his mother, Kristen Lucky, in South Carolina. Today, all of Cyrus's maternal siblings are established entertainers. Trace is a vocalist and guitarist for the electronic pop band Metro Station. Noah is an actress and, along with brazen, models, singers, and songwriters. Brandy was formerly a musician for the indie rock band Frank and Dural and is a professional DJ. Cyrus's godmother is entertainer Dolly Parton. Cyrus attended Heritage Elementary School in Williamson County, when her family lived in Thompson Station, Tennessee. When she was hired for Hannah Montana, the family moved to Los Angeles, where she attended options for youth charter schools and studied with a private tutor on set. Raised a Christian, she was baptized in a Southern Baptist church before moving to Hollywood in 2005. She attended church regularly while growing up and wore a purity ring. In 2001, when Cyrus was 8, she and her family moved to Toronto, Ontario, Canada while her father filmed the television series Doc. After Billy Ray took her to see a 2001 Mirvish production of Mamma Mia. At the Royal Alexandra Theatre, Cyrus grabbed his arm and told him, "This is what I want to do, Daddy. I want to be an actress." She began singing and acting lessons at the Armstrong Acting Studio in Toronto. Cyrus's debut acting role was portraying a girl named Kylie in her father's television series Doc. In 2003, Cyrus received credit under her birth name for her role as young Ruthie in Tim Burton's Big Fish. During this period, she auditioned with Taylor Lautner for the feature film The Adventures of Sharkboy and Lavagirl in 3D. Although she was one of two finalists for the role, she chose Hannah Montana instead. Her mother Tish Cyrus became Miley's manager, and worked to acquire a team to build her career. Cyrus signed with Mitchell Gossett, director of the youth division at Cunningham Escott's Levin Doherty. Gossett is often credited with discovering Cyrus, and played a key role in her auditioning for Hannah Montana. She later signed with Jason Morey of Morey Management Group to handle her music career, having been directed to him by Dolly Parton. She hired her father's finance manager as part of her team. 2003-2009, Hannah Montana and early musical releases. Cyrus at Macy's Thanksgiving Parade in 2008. Cyrus auditioned for the Disney Channel television series Hannah Montana when she was 11 years old. She auditioned for the role of the title character's best friend, but was called to audition for the lead role instead. Despite being denied the part at first because she was too young and small for the role, she was selected later as the lead because of her singing and acting abilities. The series premiered in March 2006 to the largest audience for a Disney Channel program, and quickly ranked among the highest-rated series on basic cable. The success of the series led to Cyrus being labeled a teen idol. She toured with the Cheetah Girls as Hannah Montana in September 2006, performing songs from the show's first season. Walt Disney Records released a soundtrack credited to Cyrus' character in October of that year. The record was a commercial success, topping the Billboard 200 chart in the United States. It went on to sell over 3 million copies worldwide. With the release of the soundtrack, Cyrus became the first act within the Walt Disney Company to have deals in television, film, consumer products, and music. Cyrus performs at Auburn Hills during the Wonder World Tour, 2009. Cyrus signed a 4-album recording contract with Hollywood Records to distribute her non-Hannah Montana soundtrack music. She released the 2-disc album Hannah Montana 2, Meet Miley Cyrus in June 2007. The first disc was credited as the second soundtrack by Hannah Montana, while the second disc served as Cyrus' debut studio album. The album became her second to reach the top of the Billboard 200, and has sold over 3 million copies since its release. Months after the release of the project, See You Again, 2007, was released as the lead single from the album. The song was a commercial success, and has sold over 2 million copies in the United States since its release. She then collaborated with her father on the single Ready, Set, Don't Go, 2007. Cyrus embarked on her highly successful Best of Both Worlds tour, 2007-08, to promote its release. Ticketmaster officials commented that there'd been a demand of this level or intensity since the Beatles or Elvis. The tour's success led to the theatrical release of the 3D concert film Hannah Montana and Amp, Miley Cyrus, Best of Both Worlds Concert, 2008. While initially intended to be a limited release, the film's success led to a longer run. Cyrus and friend Mandy Gira began posting videos on the popular website YouTube in February 2008, referring to the clips as the Miley and Mandy Show. The videos garnered a large online following. In April 2008, several images of Cyrus in her underwear and swimsuit were leaked by a teenage hacker who accessed her Gmail account. Further controversy arose when it was reported that Cyrus, then 15, had posed topless during a photo shoot with Annie Leibovitz for Vanity Fair. The New York Times later clarified that although the pictures left the impression that she was bare-breasted, Cyrus was wrapped in a bed sheet and was not topless. Cyrus went on to release her second studio album, Breakout, 2008, in June of that year. The album boasted the highest first-week sales of her career thus far, and became her third to top the Billboard 200. Cyrus later starred with John Travolta in the animated film Bolt, 2008, her debut as a theatrical actress. The film was a critical and commercial success, earning her a Golden Globe nomination. In March 2009, Cyrus released The Climb, 2009, as a single from the soundtrack to the Hannah Montana feature film. It was met with a warm critical and commercial reaction, becoming a crossover hit in both pop and country music formats. The soundtrack, which features the single, went on to become Cyrus' fourth entry to top the Billboard 200. This made her, at 16, the youngest performer in history to have four number one albums on the chart. She released her fourth soundtrack as Hannah Montana in July 2009, which debuted at number two on the Billboard 200. Cyrus later launched her first fashion line, Miley Cyrus and Max Azrea, through Walmart. It was promoted by the release of Party in the USA, 2009, and the EP The Time of Our Lives, 2009. Cyrus said the album was a transitioning album, really to introduce people to what I want my next record to sound like, and with time I will be able to do that a little more. Party in the USA went on to become one of Cyrus' most successful singles to date, and is considered one of her signature songs. She next embarked on her first world tour, the Wonder World Tour, 2009, which was a critical and commercial success. On December 7, 2009, Cyrus performed for Queen Elizabeth II and other members of the British royal family at the Royal Variety Performance in Blackpool, Lancashire. Billboard ranked her as the fourth best-selling female artist of 2009. 2010-2012, Can't Be Tamed and Focus on Acting. Hoping to foster a more mature image, Cyrus starred in the film The Last Song, 2010, based on the Nicholas Sparks novel. It garnered a generally negative critical reaction, though it was a box office hit. Cyrus further attempted to change her image with the release of her third studio album, Can't Be Tamed, 2010. The album featured a more dance-oriented sound than her prior releases, and caused a considerable amount of controversy because of its lyrical content and Cyrus' live performances. It sold 106,000 copies in its first week of release, and became her first studio album not to top the Billboard 200 chart in the United States. Due to the controversy surrounding the release, the album's second and final single, Who Owns My Heart, was released solely in select European territories. Cyrus released her final soundtrack as Hannah Montana that October. It was a commercial failure. Cyrus performs during her Gypsy Heart tour in Sao Paulo, 2011. Cyrus was the center of more controversy when a video posted online in December 2010 showed a then 18 Cyrus smoking salvia with a bong. 2010 ended with her ranked number 13 on Forbes Celebrity 100 list. She embarked on her worldwide Gypsy Heart Tour, 2011, in April, which featured no North American dates. Cyrus cited her various controversial moments as the reason behind this, claiming she only wanted to travel where she felt the most love. Following the release of Can't Be Tamed, Cyrus officially parted ways with longtime record label Hollywood Records. With Hannah Montana now officially over, Cyrus announced that she planned to take a hiatus from music to focus on her film career. She later confirmed she would not be going to college for the time being. Cyrus hosted the March 5, 2011, episode of Saturday Night Live, during which she performed in a number of skits and poked fun at her recent controversies. She later made an appearance on the MTV series Punk'd, appearing with Kelly Osbourne and Khloe Kardashian. Cyrus starred in the independent film LOL, 2012, with Demi Moore. The film had a limited release, and was critically and commercially unsuccessful. She then starred in the comedy film So Undercover, appearing as an FBI agent who is required to go undercover at a college sorority. Cyrus released a string of live performances known as the Backyard Sessions through YouTube during the spring and summer of 2012. The performances were of classic songs that Cyrus personally liked. Having begun working on a failed fourth album the previous year, Cyrus resumed working on a new musical project in late 2012. She collaborated with producers Rock Mafia on their song Morning Sun, 2012, which was made available for free download online. She had previously appeared in the music video for their debut single, The Big Bang, 2010. Cyrus later provided guest vocals on Decisions, 2012, by Borgore. Both Cyrus and Hemsworth appeared in the music video for the track. She went on to appear as Missy in two episodes of the CBS sitcom Two and a Half Men. Cyrus generated considerable media attention after cutting her traditionally long, brown hair in favor of a blonde, pixie cut. She commented that she had never felt more in whole life and that it really changed life. 2013-2015, Bangerz and Miley Cyrus and Amp, Her Dead Pets. Cyrus performs on the Bangerz tour in Vancouver in February 2014. In 2013, Cyrus hired Larry Rudolph to be her manager. Rudolph is best known for representing Britney Spears. It was soon confirmed that Cyrus had signed a new recording contract with RCA Records to distribute her future releases. She worked with producers such as Pharrell Williams and Mike Will made it on her fourth studio album, resulting in a hip-hop influenced sound. She collaborated with numerous hip-hop artists' releases and appeared on the Snoop Lion song Ashtrays and Heartbreaks, 2013, released as the lead single from his 12th studio album, Reincarnated, in April 2013. She worked with Will.i.am on the song Fall Down, 2013. Released as a promotional single that same month. The song entered the Billboard Hot 100 at number 58, marking her first appearance on the chart since Can't Be Tamed, 2010. She provided guest vocals on the Lil Twist song Twerk, which also featured vocals by Justin Bieber. The song went unreleased for unknown reasons, though it was leaked online. On May 23, 2013, it was confirmed that Cyrus would be featured on the Mike Will Made It single 23, with Wiz Khalifa and Juicy J. The single went on to peak at number 11 on the Hot 100, and had sold over 1 million copies worldwide as of 2013. Cyrus released her new single We Can't Stop on June 3. Touted as her comeback single, it went on to become a worldwide commercial success, topping the charts in territories such as the United Kingdom. The song's music video set the Vivo record for most views within 24 hours of release, and became the first to reach 100 million views on the site. Cyrus performed with Robin Thicke at the 2013 MTV Video Music Awards, a performance that resulted in widespread media attention and public scrutiny. Her simulated sex acts with a foam finger were described as disturbing, and the whole performance as cringeworthy. Cyrus released Wrecking Ball, 2013, as the second single from Bangerz on the same day as the VMAs. The accompanying music video showing her swinging naked on a wrecking ball was viewed over 19 million times within its first day of release. The single became Cyrus' first single to top the Hot 100 chart in the United States, having sold over 2 million copies. Cyrus performing at the 2013 Jingle Ball in Tampa, Florida. On October 2, MTV aired the documentary Miley, The Movement, that chronicled the recording of her fourth studio album Bangerz, which was released on October 4. It was a commercial success, debuting at number 1 on the Billboard 200 with first week sales of 270,000 copies. On October 5, Cyrus hosted Saturday Night Live for the second time. On November 5, rapper Future's Real and True was released as a single featuring Cyrus and Mr. Hudson. An accompanying music video premiered 5 days later on November 10, 2013. In late 2013, she was declared Artist of the Year by MTV. On January 29, 2014, she played an acoustic concert show on MTV Unplugged, performing songs from Bangerz featuring a guest appearance by Madonna. It became the highest-rated MTV Unplugged in the past decade with over 1.7 and NBSP million streams. Cyrus was also featured in the Marc Jacobs Spring 2014 ad campaign along with Natalie Westling and Esmeralda C. Reynolds. She launched her controversial Bangerz Tour, 2014, that year, which received a generally positive reception. About 2 months into her tour, Cyrus Alaskan Clay Kai was found mauled to death at her home after fighting with a coyote. The trauma from the incident inspired her to dedicate her life to veganism. 2 weeks later, Cyrus suffered an allergic reaction to the antibiotic cefalexin, prescribed to treat a sinus infection, resulting in her hospitalization in Kansas City. Though she rescheduled some of her U.S. tour dates, she resumed the tour 2 weeks later, beginning with the European leg. While collaborating with the Flaming Lips on their remake of the Beatles' Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band, Cyrus began working with Wayne Coyne on her fifth studio album. She claimed that she was taking her time to focus on the music, and that the album would not be released until she felt it was ready. Coyne compared his collaborative material with Cyrus to the catalogs of Pink Floyd and Portishead, and described their sound as being a slightly wiser, sadder, more true version of Cyrus' pop music output. Cyrus also worked on the films The Night Before, 2015, and A Very Merry Christmas, 2015. During this period, both roles were cameos. Reports began to surface in 2015 that Cyrus was working on two albums simultaneously, one of which she hoped to release at no charge. This was confirmed by her manager, who claimed she was willing to end her contract with RCA Records if they refused to let her release a free album. Cyrus was the host of the 2015 MTV Video Music Awards, making her the first openly pansexual host of those awards, and gave a surprise performance of a new song, Do It, 2015, during the show's finale. Immediately following the performance, Cyrus announced that her fifth studio album, Miley Cyrus and Amp, Her Dead Pets, 2015, was available for free streaming on SoundCloud. The album was written and produced primarily by Cyrus, and has been called experimental and psychedelic, with elements of psychedelic pop, psychedelic rock, and alternative pop. 2016-2017, The Voice and Younger Now. Cyrus performing at the Capital Pride Festival in June 2017. In 2016, following the release of her fifth studio album the previous year, Cyrus resumed working on her upcoming sixth studio album. She was a key advisor during the 10th season of the reality singing competition The Voice. In March, it was announced that Cyrus had signed on as a coach for the 11th season of The Voice as a replacement for Gwen Stefani. Cyrus is the youngest judge to appear in any incarnation of the series. In September 2016, Cyrus CO starred in Crisis in 6 Scenes, a television series Woody Allen created for Amazon Studios. She plays the part of a radical activist who causes chaos in a conservative 1960s household while hiding from the police. On September 17, 2016, she appeared on The Tonight Show starring Jimmy Fallon, where she sang Bob Dylan's Baby, I'm in the Mood for You, a rendition that Fallon called fantastic. On May 11, 2017, Cyrus released Malibu as the lead single from her sixth album. The single debuted at number 64 on the Billboard Hot 100 and peaked at number 10 on the chart on its second week. On June 9, Cyrus released Inspired after performing the song at the One Love Manchester benefit concert. It serves as a promotional single from her upcoming album. On August 8, Cyrus announced that her sixth studio album would be titled Younger Now and would be released on September 29, 2017. The album's title track was released as the second single from the album on August 18, and debuted and peaked at number 79 on the Billboard Hot 100. On August 27, Cyrus performed the track at the 2017 MTV Video Music Awards. On September 15, she performed Malibu, Younger Now, See You Again, Party in the USA and a cover of Roberta Flack's The First Time Ever I Saw Your Face for the BBC Radio 1 Live Lounge. Cyrus also returned as a coach in the 13th season of The Voice after taking a one-season hiatus. On October 5, 2017, Cyrus confirmed that she would not be returning to The Voice for season 14. On October 30, 2017, Cyrus said she would not tour for or release any further singles from Younger Now. 2018 present, she is Miley Cyrus. Before the release of Younger Now in September 2017, Cyrus expressed she was already two songs deep on the next. Producers attached to her seventh studio album include previous collaborator Mike Will Made It and new collaborators Mark Ronson and Andrew Wyatt. Her first collaboration with Ronson, Nothing Breaks Like a Heart from his 2019 album Late Night Feelings, was released on November 29, 2018. On May 31, 2019, Cyrus tweeted that her seventh studio album would be titled She Is Miley Cyrus and would comprise of 3 6-song EPs, which would be released before the full-length album, She Is Coming on May 31, She Is Here in the Summer, and She Is Everything in the Fall. She Is Coming debuted at number 5 on the US Billboard 200 with 36,000 album equivalent units, while the single Mother's Daughter entered at number 54 on the US Billboard Hot 100. Cyrus starred in Rachel, Jack, and Ashley 2, an episode of the British science fiction series Black Mirror, which she filmed in South Africa in November 2018. It was released on Netflix on June 5, 2019. In the episode, she portrays the fictional pop star Ashley O and provides the voice for her AI doll extension, Ashley 2. The music video for the song On a Roll from the episode was released on June 13. The song itself and the B-side Right Where It Belongs were released to digital platforms the following day. On June 27, it was announced that Cyrus had collaborated with Ariana Grande and Lana Del Rey for the theme song of the 2019 film Charlie's Angels. Artistry, musical style and influences. MW parser output. Tumulty. Thumbinner. MW parser output. Tumulty. Tro. MW parser output. Tumulty. Single. MW parser output. Tumulty. Theater. MW parser output. Tumulty. Thumb caption. MW parser output. Tumulty. Text align left. MW parser output. Tumulty. Text align right. MW parser output. Tumulty. Text align center at media all end. Max width 720px. MW parser output. Tumulty. Tro. MW parser output. Tumulty. Single. MW parser output. Tumulty. Thumb caption. Elvis Presley and Madonna have influenced Cyrus. Cyrus cites Elvis Presley as her biggest inspiration. She has also cited artists such as Madonna, Dolly Parton, Timbaland, Joan Jett, Lil Kim, Shania Twain, Hanson, One Republic, and Britney Spears as influences. Since the start of her musical career, Cyrus has been described as being predominantly a pop artist. Her Hannah Montana 2, Meet Miley Cyrus debut studio effort was characterized as sounding similar to her releases as Hannah Montana featuring a pop rock and bubblegum pop sound. Cyrus hoped that the release of Breakout, 2008, would help distance her from this sound. The project features Cyrus experimenting with various genres. Cyrus Co. wrote 8 songs for the album, and was quoted as saying, "I just hope this record showcases that, more than anything, I'm a writer." The songs on her early releases feature lyrics on the topics of love and relationships. Cyrus's vocal range is mezzo-soprano, but according to MTV.com, her vocals were once described as an alto, with a Nashville twang in both her speech and singing voice. On Party in the USA 2009, Her vocals feature belter refrains, while those on the song Obsessed, 2009, are described as husky. Releases such as The Climb, 2009, and These Four Walls, 2008, feature elements of country music and showcase Cyrus's twangy vocals. Cyrus experiments with an electropop sound on Fly on the Wall, 2008, a genre that she would explore further with the release of Can't Be Tamed, 2010, her third studio album. It was initially intended to feature rock music elements prior to its completion, and Cyrus claimed after its release that it could be her final pop album. The album's songs speak of Cyrus' desire to achieve freedom in both her personal life and her career. She began working on Bangerz, 2013, during a musical hiatus, and described the project as having a Dirty South feel prior to its release. Critics noted the use of hip-hop music and synth-pop in the album. The album's songs are placed in chronological order, telling the story of her failed relationship with Liam Hemsworth. Cyrus described Miley Cyrus and Amp, Her Dead Pets, 2015, as a little psychedelic, but still in that pop world. Stage performances. Cyrus has become known for her controversial performances, such as during her Bangerz tour, 2014, and Milky Milky Milk tour, 2015. Her performance of Party in the USA at the 2019 Choice Awards sparked a national uproar because of her outfit and her perceived pole dancing. She faced similar controversy following a performance of Can't Be Tamed, 2010, on Britain's Got Talent, where she pretended to kiss one of her female dancers on stage. Cyrus defended the performance, feeling she did nothing wrong. Cyrus was the subject of public and media scrutiny following her performance of We Can't Stop, 2013, and Blurred Lines, 2013, with Robin Thicke at the 2013 MTV Video Music Awards. Clad in a skin-colored latex two-piece, Cyrus touched Thicke's crotch area with a giant foam finger and twerked against his crotch. Shortly thereafter, the word twerk was added to the online version of the Oxford Dictionary of English. The performance resulted in a media frenzy. One reviewer likened the performance to a bad acid trip, while another described it as a train wreck in the classic sense of the word, as the audience reaction seemed to be a mix of confusion, dismay, and horror in a cocktail of embarrassment. Cyrus entered the stage of her Bangerz tour, 2014, by sliding down a slide in the shape of a tongue, gaining media attention during the tour for her costumes and racy performances. Philanthropy. Throughout her career, Cyrus has sung on several charity singles such as Just Stand Up, Send It On, Everybody Hurts, and We Are the World 25 for Haiti. She has visited a number of sick fans in hospitals throughout the years. She is an avid supporter of the City of Hope National Medical Center in California, having attended benefit concerts in 2008, 2009, and 2012. In 2008 and 2009, during her Best of Both Worlds and Wonder World tours, for every concert ticket sold, she donated $1 to the organization. Cyrus celebrated her 16th birthday at Disneyland by delivering a $1 and NBSP, million donation from Disney to Youth Service America. In July 2009, Cyrus performed at the Elizabeth Glazer Pediatric AIDS Foundation's 20th annual A Time for Heroes celebrity picnic and donated several items, including autographed merchandise and a script from Hannah Montana for the Ronald McDonald House auction. Cyrus supports charities such as the Elton John AIDS Foundation, Entertainment Industry Foundation, Habitat for Humanity, United Service Organizations, Youth Service America, and Music for Relief. In February 2010, she donated several items, including the dress she wore to the 52nd Annual Grammy Awards, and two tickets to the Hollywood premiere of her movie The Last Song, to raise money for the victims of the 2010 Haiti earthquake. Cyrus performing at the Kids' inaugural We Are the Future concert in 2009. In January 2011, Cyrus met an ailing fan with spina bifida with the charity Kids Wish Network. In April 2011, she appeared in a commercial for the American Red Cross asking people to pledge $10 to help those affected by the 2011 Japan earthquake and tsunami. In the same year, Hilary Duff presented Cyrus with the first ever Global Action Youth Leadership Award at the first annual Global Action Awards Gala for her support of Blessings in a Backpack, an organization that works to feed hungry children in schools, and her personal Get Her Good On campaign with the Youth Services of America. Cyrus stated, "I want kids to do something they love. Not something that seems like a chore because someone tells them that's the right thing to do or what their parents want or what's important to people around them, but what's in their heart." In December 2011, she appeared in a commercial for the charity J/P Haitian Relief Organization, and teamed up with her elder brother Trace Cyrus to design a limited edition t-shirt and hoodie for charity. All proceeds from the sale of these items went to her charity, Get Her Good On, which supports education for underprivileged children. In the same month, she performed her song The Climb at the CNN Heroes, an all-star tribute at the Shrine Auditorium in Los Angeles. In 2012, Cyrus released a cover version of Bob Dylan's You're Gonna Make Me Lonesome When You Go featuring Jonzo West for the charity Amnesty International as a part of the album Chimes of Freedom. She also appeared in a commercial for the Rock the Vote campaign, which encouraged young people to make their voices heard by voting in the 2012 federal election. For her 20th birthday, activists at People for the Ethical Treatment of Animals, PETA, adopted a pig called Nora in her name. Cyrus also supports 39 well-known charities including Make-A-Wish Foundation, Cystic Fibrosis Foundation, ST&NBSP, Jude's Children's Research Hospital, To Write Love on Her Arms, NOH8 Campaign, Love is Louder Than the Pressure to Be Perfect and the Jed Foundation among others. In 2013, Cyrus was named the 14th most charitable celebrity of the year by Do Something. She also appeared with Justin Bieber and Pitbull in a television special entitled The Real Change Project, Artists for Education. On July 26, 2014, it was announced that Cyrus would appear alongside Justin Timberlake at an HIV/AIDS charity event in the White House. At the 2014 MTV Video Music Awards, Jimmy Fallon announced that Cyrus was the winner of the Video of the Year award for her song Wrecking Ball. Instead of accepting the award herself, she had a 22-year-old homeless man by the name of Jesse collect it for her. She had met him at My Friend's Place, an organization that helps homeless youth find shelter, work, health care, and education. His acceptance speech encouraged musicians to learn more about homeless youth in Los Angeles and what they can do to help at Cyrus's Facebook page. Cyrus then launched a Prizeo campaign to raise funds for the charity. Those who made donations were automatically entered into a sweepstake for a chance to meet Cyrus on her Bangerz tour in Rio de Janeiro that September. Happy Hippie Foundation. Cyrus is the founder of the Happy Hippie Foundation, which works to fight injustice facing homeless youth, LGBTQ youth, and other vulnerable populations. Since 2014, the foundation has served nearly 1,500 homeless youth in Los Angeles, reached more than 25,000 LGBTQ youth and their families with resources about gender, and provided social services to transgender individuals, youth in conflict zones, and people affected by crisis situations. Happy Hippie encourages Cyrus's fans to support causes including gender equality, LGBTQ rights, and mental health through awareness campaigns and fundraising. On June 15, 2015, Cyrus unleashed the campaign number InstaPride in collaboration with Instagram. The campaign features a series of portraits starring transgender and gender-expansive people, which were posted to her Instagram feed with the hashtags number Happy Hippie Presents and number InstaPride. It was aimed at encouraging diversity and tolerance by showing these people in a positive light as examples for others who might be struggling to figure themselves out, as well as a reference point for people who didn't know personally anyone in that situation. Cyrus was the one behind the camera for the photo shoot the whole time and even interviewed her 14 subjects to share their personal stories along with their portraits. She decided to predominate the color yellow since she believes it is a happy and not sexualized color. She said she wanted to bring attention and celebrate people who wouldn't normally find themselves being the stars of a photo shoot or wouldn't find themselves on the cover of a magazine. Following the loss of their Malibu home from the Woolsey fire, Cyrus and Hemsworth partnered with their community to launch the Malibu Foundation for relief efforts following the 2018 California wildfires. Through the Happy Hippie Foundation, Cyrus and Hemsworth donated $500,000 to the Malibu Foundation. Public image. Cyrus on the red carpet at the 38th People's Choice Awards in 2012. In the early years of her career, Cyrus had a generally wholesome image as a teen idol. Her fame increased dramatically following the Vanity Fair photo scandal, and it was reported that photos of Cyrus could be shopped for $2,000 apiece. In the following years, Cyrus' image continued to shift dramatically, differing from her previous teen idol status. Donny Osmond wrote of Cyrus' transition into adulthood, "Miley will have to face adulthood. As she does, she'll want to change her image, and that change will be met with adversity." The release of Can't Be Tamed, 2010, saw Cyrus officially attempting to distance herself from her teenage years, releasing controversial music videos for her songs Can't Be Tamed, 2010, and Who Owns My Heart, 2010. Her behavior generated a considerable amount of controversy throughout 2013 and 2014, though godmother Dolly Parton stated, "The girl can write. The girl can sing. The girl is smart. And she doesn't have to be so drastic. But I will respect her choices. I did it my way, so why can't she do it her way?" Cyrus was placed at number 17 on Forbes' list of the most powerful celebrities in 2014, with the magazine noting that the last time she made our list was when she was still rolling in Hannah Montana money. Now the pop singer is all grown up and courting controversy at every turn. In August 2014, it was reported that Blue Water Productions has documented her life in a comic book called Fame, Miley Cyrus, starting with her controversial 2013 MTV Video Music Awards performance to her Disney fame, and exploring her childhood in Tennessee. The comic book was written by Michael L. Frizzle and drawn by Juan Luis Rincon, and is available in both print and digital formats. In September 2010, Cyrus was ranked number 10 on Billboard magazine's first ever list of music's hottest minors of 2010, and was ranked number 21 on the 2011, and number 18 on the 2012 version of the list. In May 2013, Maxim ranked Cyrus first on their Hot 100 of the year. Cyrus was chosen by Time magazine as one of their finalists for Person of the Year in November 2013. She came in third place with 16.3% of the vote. In March 2014, Skidmore College, New York started offering a special topics sociology course entitled The Sociology of Miley Cyrus, Race, Class, Gender, and Media, which was using Miley as a lens through which to explore sociological thinking about identity, entertainment, media and fame. In 2015, Cyrus was listed as one of the 9 runners-up for the Advocate's Person of the Year. Cyrus was raised as a Christian and identified herself as such during her childhood and early adult life. Cyrus includes references to Tibetan Buddhism in the lyrics of Milky Milky Milk, 2015. Cyrus came out as pansexual to her mother when she was 14, and has said, "I never want to label myself. I am ready to love anyone that loves me for who I am. I am open." In June 2015, Time magazine reported that she also identifies as gender fluid. She was quoted as stating, "She relate to being boy or girl, and I don't have to have my partner relate to boy or girl." Cyrus is a supporter of the LGBT community, and is often vocal about her beliefs on the topic. Her song My Heart Beats for Love, 2010, was written for one of Cyrus' gay friends, while she has since claimed that London is her favorite place to perform due to its extensive gay scene. Cyrus also has an equals sign tattooed on her ring finger in support of same-sex marriage. She is the founder of the Happy Hippie Foundation, which works to fight injustice facing homeless youth, LGBTQ youth, and other vulnerable populations. Cyrus is open about her recreational use of cannabis. She told Rolling Stone in 2013 that it was the best drug on earth and called it, along with MDMA, a happy drug. While accepting the Best Video Award at the 2013 MTV Europe Music Awards, Cyrus smoked what appeared to be a joint on stage. This was removed from the delayed broadcast of the program in the United States. In a 2014 interview with W, Cyrus stated, "I love weed and I just love getting stoned." Wealth. Miley Cyrus's net worth is estimated at $200 and NBSP, million in 2017. She earned $201 and NBSP, million from sold-out concerts and $76 and NBSP, million from endorsements. Her lifetime, 2001-2017, earnings are estimated to be in excess of $360 and NBSP, million. Personal life. Cyrus with now husband Liam Hemsworth at the 38th People's Choice Awards, January 2012. While filming the last song, Cyrus began an on-again, off-again relationship with her co-star, Liam Hemsworth, in 2009. They were first engaged from May 2012 until September 2013. They rekindled their relationship in March 2016, and became re-engaged that October. In November 2018, Cyrus revealed on social media that her and Hemsworth's home had burned down in the Woolsey fire, and expressed devastation for her community and gratitude for the safety of herself, Hemsworth, and their pets. On December 23, Cyrus and Hemsworth married in a private wedding ceremony in their home in Nashville, Tennessee. She felt that her marriage, what it looks like for someone that's a queer person, like to be in a hetero relationship, and was kind of out of character for, because worn rings forever definitely didn't need it in any way. She believes the loss of their home to be the catalyst for getting married, citing that the timing felt right and that no one is promised the next day, or the next, so to be in the now as much as possible. On August 10, 2019, Cyrus announced their separation. Previously, Cyrus had a two-year relationship with actor Tyler Posey. Cyrus has stated that she dated singer and actor Nick Jonas from June 2006 to December 2007, claiming they were in love and began dating soon after they first met. Her relationship with Jonas, as well as her spoofing fellow Disney alums Selena Gomez and Demi Lovato, attracted considerable media attention. Cyrus was in a nine-month relationship with model Justin Gaston from 2008 to 2009, and was linked to model Stella Maxwell and actor Patrick Schwarzenegger in 2015. Discography. Main articles: Miley Cyrus discography, songs, and Hannah Montana discography. Studio albums. Meet Miley Cyrus, 2007. Breakout, 2008. Can't Be Tamed, 2010. Bangerz, 2013. Miley Cyrus and Amp, Her Dead Pets, 2015. Younger Now, 2017. She Is Miley Cyrus, 2019. Extended Plays. The Time of Our Lives, 2009. She Is Coming, 2019. Filmography. Main article: Miley Cyrus videography. Big Fish, 2003. Hannah Montana and Miley Cyrus, Best of Both Worlds Concert, 2008. Bolt, 2008. Hannah Montana, The Movie, 2009. The Last Song, 2010. LOL, 2012. So Undercover, 2012. Miley, The Movement, 2013. The Night Before, 2015. A Very Merry Christmas, 2015. Crisis in Six Scenes, 2016. Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2, 2017. Tours. Main article: List of Miley Cyrus live performances. Best of Both Worlds Tour, 2007-2008. Wonder World Tour, 2009. Gypsy Heart Tour, 2011. Bangerts Tour, 2014. Milky Milky Milk Tour, 2015. See also. Honorific nicknames in popular music. List of awards and nominations received by Miley Cyrus. List of best charting music artists in the United States. List of Billboard Social 50 number 1 artists.